So in this presentation, we're going to look at the wiring method for wiring lights up when they're installed in conduit. The method is different than the one we've looked at previously in our three-plate looping method using PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables. So when we employed this type of wiring system, often used in a domestic dwelling, we had an additional terminal in our batten lamp holder or ceiling rosin pendant. The center looping terminal was present. In this system, using single insulated cables, so we've now got single insulated cables for a conduit system, and the mechanical protection being provided itself by the conduit, so just thermoplastic PVC insulated cables. We can take our conductors anywhere we like within the circuit, and we're not stuck with other conductors within the actual construction of the cable. So in singles, we can wire our conductors anywhere we like, and therefore the method of connecting and wiring our lighting circuits is different to that employed in a domestic dwelling. Also, what is different is the fact that we're using 1.5 millimeter squared cables as our smallest conductor. When we were wiring our lighting circuits in my workshop in PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables, we did use 1 millimeter squared cables. We don't in conduit. The other difference is also now they're stranded copper. They are not solid conductors. So they're 1.5 as a minimum and they are stranded. The reason being is to give greater flexibility, therefore they're stranded as they're being pulled through the conduit system itself. And they found that 1 millimeter squared cable as it was being pulled into the conduit system could tend to stretch slightly. So the minimum being 1.5 and the construction being stranded copper. Because we can take the conductors anywhere we like in circuit, the back of our batten lamp holder, and this is a straight skirted batten lamp holder, only has three terminals, one in which will incorporate the neutrals, one which will have the switching line conductors, and one for the circuit protective conductors. We no longer have the looping terminal in this method. So let's have a look how we're going to wire in plastic conduit, in this case it could be in steel conduit, a lighting circuit using the conduit looping method where we can take our conductors anywhere we like in circuit. Let's see how we're going to wire a simple one-way light switch and lighting point. So we've got a pre-tubed exercise board, of which the first stage I'm going to ask my learners to do is have this one-way switch controlling this light, and then extend it to, say, a second office where there's a one-way switch controlling a light, one-way switch controlling a light, so we're at stage three. So we're going to practice the conduit looping method and build it up in three individual stages. Normally, we would be pulling the cables in using a nylon draw-through tape, one end of which I call the mouse, and then an eyelet on the other end of which we attach the cables. And we've discussed in the classroom how far we could pull a cable system through the conduit before having to withdraw it from a box and re-pull it in. However, because our conduit system is so small, we're not going to use the nylon draw-through tape in order to wire the circuit. We're simply going to push the conductors in. But be aware that we should be using one of these in industry. Also, as we're learning, we're likely to be pulling one conductor in at a time. Again, we discussed the need to pull several conductors going through one distance through a part of a conduit at the same time to avoid friction across the conductors, whereas we're going to pull one conductor in at a time to work out where they've got to go as we try to underpin the learning done in the classroom and some drawings that we've done. However, we know that we should be pulling conductors that are going in the same direction through the same piece of conduit all at the same time to avoid them passing each other and causing friction and possibly burning off the thermoplastic insulation around the conductors. Let's go and look at seeing if we can wire one-way switch here and a light fitting here from our consumer unit here using the conduit looping method. So stage one, one-way switch here, controlling the lighting point here, fed from the consumer's unit here. We can start off with a neutral conductor. The neutral only needs to appear at the lighting point itself. So we're going to go from the consumer's unit with our blue neutral to our lighting point itself. To make it a little easier for us to wire through the conduit system, prevent it catching at the adapters and boxes, I'm going to fold over the end of my cable, giving it a better chance of popping its way through. Gravity falls, so I'm going to come from the lighting point down to the actual consumer's unit. So neutral needs to be at the lighting point itself. We're going to pick that one up from the consumer's unit, being the first light on the circuit, making sure we leave ourselves plenty of cable at termination end, so we talk about at least twice as long as the consumer's unit itself. And our neutral point is at our lighting point here, and again, leave ourselves a little bit of spare of termination. So from the consumer unit, we've gone to the lighting point itself with our neutral conductor. Now we can look at wiring the CPCs. We've talked in the classroom about limiting the number of CPCs in the back of our straight skirted batten lamp holder. It will facilitate three or four CPCs, but at this stage of our learning, to make it easier, I'm going to try and limit it down to only two CPCs in the back of the straight skirted batten lamp holder. With that in mind, From the consumer's unit, we're going to take our CPC directly to our switch, and then from our switch back to our baton lamp holder. The other advantage of wiring it this way, it does make, in this case, there's only one on the circuit. The final point here on the circuit will have only one neutral, one switching line eventually, and one circuit protective conductor. And again, I like that. So the CPC is going to come from the consumer's unit directly to the switch, and from the switch back to the baton lamp holder. Again, I'm going to fold over the end. I'm going to work it back in reverse. So CPC goes in. It's got to come all the way down to the switch itself. Fold over the end. So, first part of this, CPC from the consumer's unit's gone directly to the switch, and then from the switch we're going back up to the light fitting itself. So I'm going to come down because gravity falls, making it a little easier, and pull the CPC through and cut it off to suit. So the CPC comes from the consumer's unit. In this case, we went straight to the switch, and from the switch back to the lighting point. The lighting point also has a neutral. From the consumer's unit, the neutral went straight to the lighting point itself. We've now got to look how we're going to get a switching line to the actual light fitting here. Let's look at that in the next part of the presentation. So this time we do not need the line connection to come from the consumer's unit directly to the actual fitting itself, because we have no facility for a looping terminal here, unlike when we're wiring domestically. So our permanent line connection will come from our consumer's unit, go directly to our switch and be connected into the common terminal. And then from L1, a switching line conductor will come back to the light fitting itself. So let's do that next. So again, fold over the end. This one's going to go directly to the switch, being my permanent line. So from the consumer's unit, directly to the common terminal of the one-way switch, we'll bring my permanent line in. And then from my switch, from the switch going back up to the light fitting, my switching line conductor. And again, that will be connected in L1. So folding over the end, I'm going to drop it down again because it's easier to push it down than it is up. We'll come through, and our circuit is wired. So at the lighting point itself, we only have one neutral, one switching line, and for us to make it easier, one circuit protective conductor. At the one-way switch, we have a permanent line from the consumer's unit, a switching line back to the light fitting, and two circuit protective conductors. So that's the conduit looping method. We can take our conductors anywhere we like, and we did. We took the neutral directly to the light fitting. We took the permanent line connection directly to the switch. From the switch, we took a switching line conductor back up to the lighting point. Our CPCs could go in any order we wanted, but we decided to make life a little easier in the straight skirted baton lamp holder by bringing the CPC first to the switch and then back up to the lighting point itself. And also what I like is the fact that there is only one point on this circuit at the moment, but if this was the final point on the circuit, one neutral, one switching line, and only one circuit protective conductor. Let's see if we can extend that circuit in the next part of the presentation. So we're in a position where office number one has a one-way switch controlling a lighting point, and we don't want to extend it now into the second office, so we have a one-way light switch here controlling the lighting point here. First of all, we must get a neutral to our lighting point. Our closest neutral is here, so we're simply going to take a neutral from here across to here. Let's do that next. So push my neutral across, and we have a neutral now in the second office. The circuit protective conductor, we're going to need a CPC both at the lighting point and the switch. And we said previously I'd like to make it easier and have fewer CPCs at the lighting point itself. So I'm going to come from this lighting point down to the switch, and from the switch back to the lighting point itself. Okay, and fold over the cable. I'm going to push my CPC in. Go down in length down to my light switch itself. And then back from my light switch up to my lighting point. Okay, so we have a CPC now at the lighting point and two CPCs at the light switch itself. So we took the CPC from here down to the switch and from the switch back up to the lighting point, trying to reduce the number of CPCs in order to make it easier to connect them into the straight skirted baton lamp holder. We now need to work out where we can get a permanent line connection into the common terminal of this switch. We could suggest that we come from the consumer's unit, but it's impractical to have, say, 10 coming out the top of a circuit breaker in order to do 10 different offices. The closest permanent line is at the common of this switch in this office. So we're going to come from the common here. So there'll be two in the common, both of them permanent line connections. So the common from here, so line from this common across and down to this common at this switch here. So this is where we got a little bit of variation in the wiring system compared to looking at a domestic dwelling. We've got the flexibility of picking our connections up from wherever we need them. So the permanent line is here. So let's pick it up from there. So another conductor down here. Now it's going to start to get a little trickier to get them in. So this one here, and we've got to get that all the way down to our other switch. Through we go, and down we go. So we've now got a permanent line to be able to be connected at the common terminal, hopefully. Let's try that again. So we're going to have a permanent line now down at the common terminal of this switch in office number two. So down she goes. So permanent line comes from common here over to common here, and we just simply need a switching line to return back to the lighting point itself. So let's do that next. So from the light fitting, we're going to come down to the lighting switch itself. Okay, so we've got now office number one and office number two, both one-way controlled by the switches within the rooms that they are simulating. So let's recap them for the second office. We needed a neutral at the lighting point. We took it from the neutral in the previous office. We came across. We need a CPC in this office. So we took a CPC from the baton lamp holder down to the switch and a CPC back up to the lighting point. A little bit now thinking involved, we needed a permanent line down at the switch. We got it from the permanent line, which will be the common connection of this switch. So we took a cable up, through and down to here. And then from L1, a switching line back. We can repeat this process as we move through to office number three, this switch controlling this lighting point. So we'll do the same again. Neutral will come across, CPC will go down to the switch and one back to the lighting point. From the common through to the common to link the two permanent line connections, switching line back up to the lighting point itself. Ignore this switching position, it's in case I want to create other switching positions as we move forward. So that's us looking at the conduit looping method, doing one-way switches. I hope this video has been some help.